I'm not gonna waste your time. Here's the answer. The crowbar is more deadly than any other gun in the game, full stop. Pause here to see the number comparisons. If you want to see the math and exactly how dangerous it is, that's the rest of the video. I will warn you, I'm not that good at math and might have made some critical errors, so if someone corrects me, I will be pinning any comment that points it out. Using some math and pixel counting, we can figure out that these pallets, which we can assume are 40 by 48 inches, as are the standard size across the US and Europe, are 384 pixels across. This means every 9.6 pixels equals 1 inch. The barrel is 360 pixels, or 37.7 across. We can then whack our crowbar from behind the barrel. But if we then aim upwards at a 45 degree angle, we can hit even further. Using the Pythagorean theorem and counting more pixels, we know that we are standing 37.7 inches away, and our second hit is 19.6 inches above eye level. We then know that our crowbar has traveled 42.49 inches. Then counting frames, we know how long it took. Now, for some reason, when you stand behind the pallet on the 40-inch side, we can't actually hit the wall, but this seems to be more of an issue of source jank rather than the pallet being the wrong size. I think they just gave you more range at higher angles or something, but I'm not entirely sure. I don't know, and I can't really bother to figure it out. We can also use this to figure out the crowbar's length, that being roughly 20 inches. So we then compare its weight to crowbars on Amazon and can figure out it weighs around 2.9 pounds. So, we know that the crowbar traveled 42.49 inches in 3 frames, recorded at 60 FPS, or about 0.05 seconds. This is where we switch to metric to try to make it better for conversions. We know the crowbar traveled 1.079246 meters in 0.05 seconds. Using even more math to find its final velocity, we know it is 43.16 meters a second, or 96 miles an hour at the end of its swing. Using a kinetic energy calculator, we now know it's outputting 1,125.17 joules of energy. We then use a kinematics calculator to find out its acceleration is 863.199 repeating meters per second squared. Now we need to determine what area the impact is being distributed across. Using this website, we can figure out that the pallet is 6.5 inches tall, and using some noclip, we can get a crowbar in place on top of the pallet. We then do some more pixel counting, and we know that the tip of the crowbar is incredibly thin to the point where you can occasionally see through it, so it's about 1 pixel thick. After measuring, we now know the tip of the crowbar has an area of 0.0122 square inches. Now this is where my math may be very wrong. I believe force is kinetic energy over stopping distance, which for us is technically zero as the crowbar impacts something without denting it and instead leaves behind a texture. And as far as I can tell, zero doesn't work in this equation and may even be giving us the answer of infinity. Not super sure, so we're gonna go with something between 1 to 5 centimeters of stopping distance. This gives us a force of anything between 24,000 to 120,000 newtons. Google claims you need as little as 4,000 newtons to break a femur, the strongest bone in the body. These numbers give us essentially anything between 450,000 psi up to 2.2 million psi. For reference, a bullet fired from 357 Magnum has a maximum pressure of 44,000 psi. Now, from what I could find, the energy density for the 357 Magnum would be about 7,900 joules per square inch, while the crowbar, to the best of my knowledge, is at a whopping 100,000 joules per square inch. For reference, Google tells me that you only need about 10,000 joules max to break the femur. So, when Gordon hits these guys with his crowbar, we can confidently say that they are not just pretending to die. Thanks for watching. I have about 2 ideas for future videos. Maybe I'll get those out before the summer is over.